society. So the risk manager comes here to maximize the benefits and support the benefits and minimizing the hazard factors, risk factors. That is the purpose of the safety. So yes, safety means what?
Reducing the risk.
Prevention.
You cannot live without risk. Is there any risk-free life?
No.
Can you say any hazard-free life?
No.
Can you live without a fire hazard?
No.
You cannot live. When you take a birth on this earth, you started crying. Crisis management starts there itself. Okay. So the crisis is the part and parcel of your life. So that you have to face. You born as a crisis manager. You have to run like that only. You have to live like that only. Okay. So whatever that you do, any industry take, sugar industry, plastic industry, rubber industry, any industry you take that has two hazards there. You have to minimize, protect, identify the hazards, analyze the hazards, mitigate the hazards, protect the hazards. Then that protection system, implementing the protection system is called the safety. So any hazard, any risk factors that is identified, understood, protected, mitigated, minimized, then that hazard, that risk factors is called the safety. There is no safety without risk factors at all. If there is no risk, there is no safety at all. The risks are everywhere. So we have to understand it, we must be aware of it so that you can have a protection system over it so that the risks are protected or in the buildings. Okay. See, so if the fullest room completely becomes the fire, that is called a flashover stage. That is fully developed stage. Entire room comes under the burning stage. That is called a flashover stage. So you see how much time it takes in the modern furnitures and the legacy, the traditional furniture, still it is in the starting stage only. Even it has not sustained. Still fire services has not come. See how dark smoke spreads vertical. It's called a vertical fire spread. And see, now suppose that in the even floor also, the fire can enter into that floor also.
Is it a real fire or animated one?
Real fire. Real fire. Real fire. They are fighting fire now under the ground. Now they are.
Okay. So elimination. Simple. Why should they even enter? See this. See, look at this. I'm sorry. I'm not trying to blame you. See this. This is you're using
Help the Environment, EHS. Health, Environment and Safety. That is the basic motto of this program. So health as well as environment and safety, the both are three things that makes our life more pleasant and happy. So that we are missing really. So missing in the really modern life, we missing it very much. And we do not know how we are missing it also. So it's a basically this awareness and the system that we want to have to enhance the EHS. That is the basic motto of this program.
This Ujjavaran program is directed towards developing awareness on energy efficiency, sustainability in commercial buildings like hospitals and hotels. We all know that hospitals and hotels consume almost about 30% of the energy that is produced in the country. And once we have been able to understand the various ways of containing costs, energy conservation, I think it will be good for the owners of the hospital, the promoters of the hospitals and the hospitals to really conserve energy and also save a lot of costs. For the people who have been here, we must understand hospitals consume twice the energy as hotels and malls, because in the hospitals patients stay for about almost 24 hours a day, and along with them the patient relatives also stay, and the visitors come to the hospital. Our conservation is more a social concept. It is a corporate social responsibility, and If large buildings like hotels, malls and hospitals can save about 50,000 units of power every day, and that 50,000 units of power can be used in the rural areas in the country. And I think that is a very important objective of this conference. Another is, we also want to improve the profitability. One advantage in reducing energy cost is that if you do 100 rupees business, if you make about 10 rupees profit, by reducing the energy cost by about 10 rupees, we will make 20% 20 rupees profit instead of doing another 100 rupees business.
ఏంటంటే గ్రీన్ హాస్పిటల్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్ డిఫరెంట్ ఉంటుంది. సో దాంట్లో ఇప్పుడు ఏమవుతుందంటే మనకు మన ప్రెషర్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్, మన డిజీస్ కంట్రోల్, దాని తర్వాత ఇన్ఫెక్షన్, హాస్పిటల్ కూడా ఇన్ఫెక్షన్స్ చాలా ఉంటాయి మనకి, ఆ ఇన్ఫెక్షన్ ఎట్లా కంట్రోల్ చేయాలి. కానీ ఈ హాస్పిటల్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్ ఇంకా గ్రీన్ బిల్డింగ్ రిక్వైర్మెంట్ రెండు ఆపోజిట్ ఉన్నాయి. గ్రీన్ బిల్డింగ్ ఏంటంటే మనకి ఎనర్జీ కన్సంప్షన్ తక్కువ చేయాలి, కానీ హాస్పిటల్స్ ఏంటంటే మనకి ఎనర్జీ కన్సంప్షన్ ఎక్కువ అవుతుంది. సో ఇది రెండు ఎలా చేయాలి, అట్లా చేసేసిన తర్వాత మనం లోపల క్లీన్లీనెస్ ఎట్లా మెయింటైన్ చేస్తాం, మన హెల్త్. ఇప్పుడు మెయిన్ ఏంటంటే ఒక హాస్పిటల్ అన్నప్పుడు ఒక పేషెంట్ వచ్చిన తర్వాత అతనికి ఒక హెల్దీ అట్మాస్ఫియర్ ఉండాలి, అతను రికవర్ తొందరగా కావాలి. నార్మల్ హాస్పిటల్స్ ఏమవుతున్నాయి అంటే ఆ రిక్వైర్మెంట్స్ అనేది మనం ఇవ్వలేకపోతాం కరెక్ట్గా. ఇట్స్ ఓన్లీ నాట్ అబౌట్ మెడిసిన్, ఇట్స్ మోర్ అబౌట్ ద ఎన్వైర్న్మెంట్ ఇన్ ది హాస్పిటల్. సో ద మూమెంట్ ఆ ఎన్వైర్న్మెంట్ మనం క్రియేట్ చేస్తే, మెడిసిన్తో మేబీ అతను 50% క్యూర్ అవుతాడు, కానీ ఒక ఎన్వైర్న్మెంట్ క్రియేట్ చేస్తామంటే ఇమీడియట్లీ అతను ఆ 50% క్యూర్ అయ్యేది ఇంకా ఒక 50% ముందే హీల్ బికమ్ మచ్ హెల్దీ అనమాట. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఇది. సో కానీ అది ఎట్లా అచీవ్ చేస్తాం, ఎట్లా మనం పవర్ కన్సంప్షన్ తక్కువ చేస్తాం, ఎందుకంటే హాస్పిటల్ అనేది మనకి 365 days 24/7 ఉంది. మనకి దివాళీ లేదు, దసరా లేదు, సంక్రాంతి లేదు, క్రిస్మస్ లేదు, 365 days 24/7 ఉంది. అట్లాంటి హాస్పిటల్, అట్లాంటి బిల్డింగ్ ఏదంటే పవర్ కన్సంప్షన్ ఏదైతే కన్సూమ్ చేస్తుందో దాన్ని ఎలా తగ్గించవచ్చు, దట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ ఇంపార్టెన్స్ ఆఫ్ ఈ గ్రీన్ హాస్పిటల్. దట్ ఈస్ ద మెయిన్ కాన్సెప్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది ఊర్జావరణ్ వేర్ వీఆర్ టాకింగ్ అబౌట్ సేవింగ్ ద ఎనర్జీ, సేవింగ్ పవర్, సేవింగ్ మనీ, సేవింగ్ అవర్ రికరింగ్ కాస్ట్.
Access fire vehicle should come there, and so that the emergency vehicle can be operated like this. So, and this is the fire rating, the cable should be protected with the fire resistance rating so that it will not start fire immediately. And the seals come, the holes are sealed.
Is being conducted by Ishre, sensitized people, various measures that are required to be taken in the hospital as well as the hospitality, that is the hotel industry. As technology is improving, there are new designs, new products of energy insulation.
Energy sanitization and air conditioning engineers has been conducting Ujjavaran for over 7 years now. And Urjavaran is creating awareness on energy conservation while maintaining the sustainable environment position. So this, we are doing it in all A-grade cities and B-grade cities and for last few years we have also taken this to Colombo and Bangladesh in the recent past. So the whole objective of this is to create awareness about energy conservation and designing the sustainable energy saving air conditioning systems. Not only the air conditioning system, but wherever the energy is there and how much we contribute for that. In any commercial building, normally about
50 feet, we want to contribute for this energy conservation. Urja, as we all know, is the energy and